Want to download and play NeoForge mods in your world? Well, that's what I'll show you in today's video. This video will show you how to download mods using the NeoForge mod loader, a hard fork of the Forge mod loader. Chapters are provided in the video for you to navigate to the section you want. The first two steps is for those who want to download NeoForge for the Minecraft launcher. If you want to play NeoForge on a mod launcher, which I suggest for playing modded, skip to this moment in the video as the first two chapters are not required. For those who just want to use the Minecraft launcher, proceed to the first step. For NeoForge mods, we'll need to download the NeoForge mod loader. Search for Minecraft NeoForge on your web browser and click the link that takes you to neoforged.net. Click the NeoForge installer button here. At the time of this recording, NeoForge is still quite new, only being available for 1.20.1 and 1.20. Before we install, make sure to create and run your selected version of Minecraft once, and have it closed during the installation. With my case, I'll create and run a 1.20.1 installation now, and close both the game and the launcher once it's done. With NeoForge downloaded, open the installer. If nothing happens, or if you recently installed Java, right-click the file and select Open with Java. A menu like this should pop up. You have the option to install NeoForge either for client, essentially single-player, or server-side for multiplayer. For most cases, select client. After confirming your directory is correct, press OK. Once NeoForge is installed, press OK and run Minecraft. Now, you should see a new installation profile of NeoForge for your chosen Minecraft version displayed here. If not, select the drop-down menu and you should see it here. At the time of this recording, your NeoForge profile might be labeled as Forge. This is so the mod loader maintains compatibility with Minecraft launchers for the time being. As long as you see a fox icon, you have NeoForge. Now, go and run Minecraft with NeoForge once, and close it once you've loaded into the game. To download and install mods, skip to this section of the video now. If you're using a mod launcher, you can install the NeoForge mod loader straight into your instance. At the time of this recording, AT Launcher is the only one to install NeoForge automatically, so that's what I'll use. But for those of you in the future who want to use NeoForge for a different mod launcher like Prism or Modrinth, then the following steps would be similar. In the AT Launcher, create a new instance by selecting the Vanilla Packs button. Select which version of Minecraft you want to use, which for me will be 1.20.1. Now you have the option to select which mod loader you want. Since we're wanting to install NeoForge, select it here, and the version of NeoForge you want downloaded, and click Create Instance. Once created, go into the Instances tab and run the NeoForge instance you just created once, and close it once you've loaded into the game. Now we want to download a mod of our choosing. If you're not sure which mod you want to download, Modrinth and CurseForge offer a wide range of mods to choose from. For this video, I'm going to download the Ad Astra mod by the Terrarium team on Modrinth. Make sure to read through the mod page to see if there's any mods that are required for this mod to run properly. Ad Astra requires the following three mods to be installed: Resourceful Library, Resourceful Config, and Potarium. Ad Astra also cannot run with Optifine, so keep that in mind. To download the mod, you can view the featured versions of the mod on either the left or right hand side. Or, if you can't find the version you want, go to the Files or Versions tab and find it through there. Since I'm using 1.20.1, I'll download the version 1.15.2 of the mod. Make sure when you download the mod that the mod is for NeoForge, otherwise it won't work when you run the game. Now proceed to download the other required mods. Once your mod or mods are downloaded, we'll need to navigate to the Minecraft directory. For those using the Minecraft launcher, head over to the Installations tab. Hover over the installation you want to install the mod on and click this folder icon. This will take you to the Minecraft directory. Go into the mods folder. If you don't have a mods folder, create one and call it mods, all in lowercase. Now, drag your chosen mod or mods into the mods folder and run Minecraft. To see if our mod or mods are installed, load into a world in Creative, and you should find it either in a separate category or amongst the default creative tabs. Do note that some mods may conflict with one another. If that's the case with you, you'll have to do some troubleshooting to determine which mod or mods are causing the conflict. If you're using a mod launcher like the AT launcher, you can download and install mods directly from the launcher into your current instance. To do this, go to your instance in the Instances tab and select Add Mods. You can sort through mods from Modrinth or CurseForge via this drop-down menu. For me, I'm going to download the Ad Astra mod. Select your chosen mod for download. Read through the description of your mod to see if there's any mod dependencies. If so, select those to download as well and confirm the download. Now you can run your Minecraft instance and your mods should be there. To see if our mod or mods are installed, load into a world in Creative and you should find it either in a separate category or amongst the default Creative tabs. Do note that some mods may conflict with one another. If that's the case with you, you'll have to do some troubleshooting to determine which mod or mods are causing the conflict. That's how to download NeoForge and NeoForge mods. For those of you who want to use a different mod loader or want to get started in finding mods, check out these videos here.